wake up, you're going to wake up.
On April 10th, 2019, the world saw the very first image of a black hole. The images of black holes prior to this were all simulations done by supercomputers based on the theoretical equations available. For example, the event horizon of a black hole we see in the movie Interstellar is an artistic simulation of what a black hole would actually look like. So what is it about the image of a black hole that created such a huge excitement all across the world, especially among the scientific community? The story goes back to about 100 years ago when Albert Einstein gave us a new description of the force of gravity, in which gravity exerts its force in terms of warps and curves in the fabric of space and time. Just a couple of years later, Karl Schwarzschild, a German astronomer, somehow got hold of Einstein's manuscripts and realized something amazing. If you take a spherical object and squeeze it down to a sufficiently small size, according to Einstein's math, the gravitational pull will be so enormous that nothing will be able to escape, not even light. And that is what a black hole is. In the successive decades, theoretical developments began to mount, showing that black holes are the inevitable outcome of massive stars that had used up their nuclear fuel, undergone a supernova explosion, and the resulting core would have no ability to withstand the pull of gravity when it collapsed down into a black hole. Now let's come back to the image. The image that was released is that of a black hole in the galaxy M87, 55 million light years away. At its heart is a 6.5 billion solar mass black hole. That is, 6.5 billion suns compressed into a single point. Capturing the picture of a black hole from such a distance is like capturing the image of an orange at the surface of the moon from Earth. Due to a fraction called diffraction, there are fundamental limits to the smallest objects that we can see. In order to see smaller and smaller, we need to make the telescope bigger and bigger. So in order to take a picture of a black hole, we needed a telescope the size of the Earth, which seemed a bit impractical an idea. So the Event Horizon Telescope project, a global collaboration of more than 200 scientists, used an array of observatories scattered around the world, from Hawaii to the South Pole. Combining all of them acted like a telescope the size of the Earth. 8 observatories in Mexico, Hawaii, Arizona, Chile, Spain, France, and the South Pole aimed their eyes into the sky and stared at M87. Light had to come from the black hole through intergalactic space, through the Earth's atmosphere where water vapor can absorb it. For several days, the team observed M87 in short radio wavelengths. Because radio waves can pierce the murky shrouds of dust and gas surrounding galactic centers. Each telescope in the worldwide network works together, linked through atomic clocks, and teams of researchers freeze light at each of the sites by collecting thousands of terabytes of data. The data collected from these observatories was so huge that they couldn't send them over the internet. All this data was shipped to one place in physical hard drives, and then massive computers began to try and analyze it. The way that technique works is, imagine taking an optical mirror and smashing it and putting all the shards in different places. The way that normal mirror works is, the light rays bounce off the surface and they focus on a certain point at the same time. The scientists took these recordings with atomic clock precision and later aligned them perfectly in the supercomputer, recreating kind of an Earth-sized lens. Katie Bauman, one of the leading engineers of the project, helps us understand it by trying to imagine it like a giant disco ball. Each individual will collect light that could then combine together to make a picture. Now, if we remove all the mirrors so that only a few remained, we could still try to combine this information together, but now there are a lot of holes. And these remaining holes represent the locations where we have the telescopes, which is an incredibly small number of measurements to make a picture from. But all the light is collected at a few telescope locations, as the Earth rotates, we get to see other new measurements. The imaging algorithms later fill in the missing gaps of the disco ball in order to reconstruct the underlying black hole image. Since combining observations from different observatories is no simple task, 4 teams process the data independently using different algorithms and testing it against different models. In the end, the images each team produced were very similar, suggesting that the observations are robust and the final snapshot is the most accurate possible. The image provides the first direct test of Einstein's theory in the strong gravitational field of a black hole. These images can be used to further study the way of the universe, which we as humans are only beginning to comprehend.